Excuse me. Hi. Are you busy? Do you know if the doctors are gonna come back to experiment on you some more? They're not? Okay. I've been wanting to meet you for a long time. Do you mind if I sit down in the chair? Okay, thanks. I have to take off my backpack, okay? I'm sorry, I don't mean to intrude, but like I said, I was trying to meet you for a really long time. I'm just real shy. I was just in the experiment room next door, and I heard that you were getting some treatments at the same time I was, and so I thought that I would go back to my room. Pack up a whole bunch of my favorite things in my backpack, in my big boy backpack, and that I would come back here and wait for the doctors to be done with you, and finally just get up the nerve to visit you, and say hi, and maybe show you some of my favorite things. Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Benjamin. But you can call me Oliver. I like that name more. My parents, they named me Benjamin, but I wish they named me Oliver. I like that name. I like that name more. So, it's nice to meet you too. I like your name a lot. Yeah, I do. No, I mean it. I heard so much about you though, that you were going to be the one to save everybody. Is that a tooth? Is that a big tooth? Or is that a non-tooth? No, not a tooth, like a tooth, like a tooth, like you told a tooth or you told a lie. The professor says, never tell a lie or you go to Margaret's Garden. I don't like going to Margaret's Garden at all. Do you like going to Margaret's Garden? Have you ever been buried there? I don't like it. It's scary. Whenever somebody gets in trouble around here, they always get buried in Margaret's Garden. I don't like it because there's creepy crawly bugs and there's weird things buried there. Growing there, like fingers and arms and brains and even like fruits and vegetables that talk. That's scary. That scares me. So I try not to get in trouble. I don't tell any lies. I always tell truths. And I eat my vegetables. Things like that. But I could get in big trouble being here. But I think that. I think you said they're not coming back, wait. Okay. So I'm just really excited to meet you. This is like, wow. This is like the biggest thing ever to happen. You're the one that everybody says. No, they say it. They do. I heard it. Said that you're gonna save us all from the professor. And you're gonna make him to be good, and you're gonna save Corvus, and Dave, and Mr. Wino, and everybody, and make this place better. Is that a truth? You don't know? You don't know that you're the one? Wow. Well, I mean, I think you are. That's what everybody says. But, well, anyway, so I'm really excited to meet you. I bought you some of my favorite things in the whole world. And this is my big boy backpack. I used to have a school bag, but I like carrying this because it makes me feel like I'm older and bigger, like an adult. So, how old am I? I think I'm 8 years old. That's what the doctor said. I'm 8 years old. I think so. I mean, I look older than that, but I don't know. Anyway, do you want to see what I bought you? I thought that I'd bring you some of my favorite things that you can have them, because if you are like me and everybody else that's here, and sometimes you get sad, or sometimes you get angry and really mad, or sometimes you get scared or anxious, or you worry a lot, you think about things, bad things sometimes, and you just lots of things that are not nice, and you don't know what to do about it. So I got some of my favorite things that I'm gonna show you that you can have them. I'll let you borrow them, okay? And then maybe they'll help you to relax. And is that okay? Okay. Where should I start with? First, I have some things inside here, inside and the side. So this heavy. I have some things in the side pocket, in the front pocket, and then this other side pocket too. Okay. What's that? My tattoos? Oh, these things? Yeah. I don't ever remember getting those before. I don't know where they come from. They scare me. I don't like to look at them though. It's like a scary snake. It's a snake or something coming out of a skull. And then this one, it's like scary face man or something. And then there's a spider. Black widow spider on my shoulder. I don't ever remember getting those before, but I must have done it. So, anyway, let me show you some of my things. First I opened up this one. You don't mind if I visit you, do you? Okay, because I forgot to ask you. I know I said, are you busy, but let me just open this one. Do you like it here a lot? Yep, it's okay. I like it here a lot because they make it really nice and safe than being outside. I don't like going outside. It's dangerous. It's really bad. There's people, bad people, and things. But here is really nice. And they, you know, you get to play video games and movies. I want to hear one of my favorite sounds. This is one of my favorite sounds. This one sounds better. case, open this up. I'm gonna start off with my most favorite thing, my secret stash. It's right here in my secret pocket. Do you like that sound? I can do it again if you want. Yeah? Okay, I'll do it one more time. My mixtape. It says right here, Oliver's mixtape number 58. I have 2,427 mixtapes of all my favorite musics in the whole wide universe. I'll read them to you. The songs that are on here. Bang Your Head by Quiet Wyatt. Bang Your Head. Mental Health Will Drive You Mad. Metal Health. Sorry, not mental. Metal Health. It's like a play on words. And then We're Not Gonna Take It by Twisted Sister. And Sabotage by Beastie Boys, see right here. All the names of my favorite songs. I'll just keep reading them to you. Run Like Heck by Pink Floyd. It's not actually heck, it's Run Like Hell. I'm not supposed to say that one. I can get buried in Margaret's Garden if I say bad words. So I try not to say bad words. Living on a Prayer by Bon Jovi. Then Come On Eileen by Dexys Midnight Runners. And then Sweet Dreams by The Rhythmics. And then Pour Some Sugar On Me by Def Leppard. Call Me by Blondie. Another One by The Dust by Queen. Jump by Van Halen. I Love Rock and Roll by Joan Jett. Thriller by Michael Jackson. Down Under by Men at Work. Oh yeah, if you ever want to meet Michael Jackson, he's in the human ward. I think he's 2 floors above my womb. All Night Long by Lionel Richie. Once in a Lifetime by Talking Heads. Eye of the Tiger by Survivor. And Never Gonna Give You Up by Rick Astley. So yeah, this is my mixtape number 58. I thought this is one of my most special ones out of the 2,000, however many mixtapes that I have. This is one of my favorite ones. I thought you can listen to it anytime you want. You can just come to my room and listen and come borrow any of my mixtapes that you want, okay? Because you're my bestest friend. I mean, if you want to be bestest friend, we don't have to be bestest friends, but I'd like to be your bestest friend. Because I have some friends, but we got to be friends. You will be my best friend of all my friends. Okay. So let me just open this up. I'm gonna put this down on that table. because my mixtape, that side B, is 90 minutes of all my favorite songs. Almost 90 minutes. And then there is side A. You like to listen to music, right? Okay, I was just making sure. Okay. Okay, so there, you can listen to that whenever you want. The next thing I have is these little pop-ums. They're like little fireworks, but they're not really explosive. You just throw them on the ground. You don't even have to throw them that hard, and they go pop, crack, like if you were shooting a cap gun, like that. And they're all, there's some sawdust at the bottom, I guess, in case they explode, they won't catch on fire, I think. Here, I can show you, I'll open up one of them. I'll open up the bag for you. You can borrow those. See? There's like little rocks in there. I don't know. I'll show you. I can. It's gonna be hard for me to show you, but if I open it up, it'll be hard to see, I think. But maybe you'll be able to see it. There's little tiny little rocks in there. And I don't know how it works. But as soon as they crash against each other, when you fall them down, they make crack sound. So yeah. I like to take those and go out, sneak out at night, and throw them at the professor's window, or throw them into Margaret's garden, and just scare everybody. It's a lot of fun. But yeah, you have to run away really fast before you get caught, or you'll be end up in Margaret's garden. Okay, then one last thing. I stole this one. Well, I didn't really steal it. I just kind of borrowed it. Do you know who this is? It's Joey. And Joey wanted to say hi to you too. Didn't you, Joey? I like Joey. He's really nice. Joey is always happy. No matter what. Nothing gets Joey down. He's a little screwed up, but he's really nice. He just wants to help you sleep, and then sometimes he wants to help you relax. He's really nice. Just don't tell anybody that I borrowed this one, okay? Because I don't want to get in trouble. Okay, the camera's off, so they're not going to know I was here with you. I don't want to get you in trouble, okay? I'm going to let you borrow this one. When you're done with it, just bring it back to my room, okay? That's it for my secret compartment, my really secret things. I have some other things to show you, okay? This is really important. You are gonna wanna borrow this and keep it really close to you, okay? This is for my own personal collection. I went to Zed Zombie's Shoplips and I bought it there. Have you ever been to Zed Zombie's Shoplips? He has all your zombie killing needs. Or all the things that you need to kill zombies, yeah. This one is really good, watch. It's a saw. So when you shoot the zombies with the trigger, here's a trigger right here. This trigger, this one, that one shoots the bullets. And the one on the bottom spins the saw blade. Spins really fast, but I'm not going to spin it really fast because it's really wild. I don't want to make a wild sound. But whenever there's a zombie outbreak here, first off, don't ever go near the zombie ward because there's always an outbreak. Or there's a zombie wandering around. I got out of his womb. It's supposed to be locked down, but they don't always have it locked down. I don't know why. The zombies are being really not nice to people. But you can have some more zombie weapons, so you don't have to worry about it. You can borrow mine, okay? Because I really wanted to meet you, and I thought you might want to use this and protect yourself from zombies. And then when you try to saw them, if you don't want to get too close to them, you can shoot them with the bullets. I'll take the bullets out. You pull this back to cock it, and then you pull the trigger, and it shoots the bullets out. There's the saw. I'll do that again for you. You want to hear that one more time? Okay. Let me take the bullets out. You can borrow that. I'll put it here on the table. Here's the bullets. You like that sound? It's a really nice sound. About you, but before when I was saying when my brain gets really stressed out, when I get sad or mad or angry, and I can't figure out what to do, I just get some of my favorite things, and I just listen to the sounds, and it lets me consummate. I focus on it, and then I stop thinking about the bad things. Do you like these sounds? Yeah. By the way, who's your favorite doctor? We have more than one. I like Dr. Dave. He's really nice. Corvus. Margaret. Sometimes the professor, but I don't really trust him too much. Then Dr. Wino, I always forget his name. Dr. Cthulhu, he's okay. He's a creepy, scary face, though. Okay, I could do that all night, but I have a lot of other things to show you. So, I have a letter J because J is for Benjamin, and that's my name. Even though I like Oliver more, I couldn't find any letters for that one. J is also for Jesus, and that's who let me borrow this. Do you like that sound too? What's that? You like the Stranger Things show? That's one of my favorite shows. Isn't it neat how we can get all the latest shows and TV shows and movies and cartoons here at the sanitarium? I think that's my favorite part. Okay, I wanted to show you that. You can borrow the letter J if you want. Let me see what else. I have this puzzle cube, but I'm not really good at solving it. I can get one side, that's about it. It makes nice tapping sounds though. I think this causes me more stress than it does more fun. But you can borrow that too, my friend. This is another one of my friends. You want to take a guess at his name? Nope. Nope. I don't think you're gonna guess it. Nope. You want me to just tell you and save you from embarrassment of never trying to get it? Yeah. Mr. Pickle. Do you wanna know why I call him Mr. Pickle? Because he doesn't like pickles. He's allergic to them. They deflate him. So, I call him Mr. Pickle. He's always happy too. You can borrow Mr. Pickle too, okay? I'll put him right there for you. This is my bug catcher. I like to go out in Margaret's garden at night and catch fireflies. You can see I put holes in there, and I put some holes in the side so they can breathe. I tried to catch some tonight for you, but it was kind of hard. They didn't want to be carted, so I just let them fly around free. Maybe next time, if you want, maybe you and me, we can go catch fireflies together. Would you like that? Okay. This makes some really nice sounds. You just have to know how to do it right. Anybody can do this. You don't have to be a magician. So you can borrow that if you want. Okay, what else? I have some video games, some favorite movies. I'll show you those too. This is one of my favorite video games. The Last Guardian. Have you ever played this one? This is where you are a little boy, and you meet a big that's you right there, little boy. He doesn't speak English. I don't know what he speaks, like different language. And then you meet Trico. That's this little like dog and bird creature. And you help him escape, and you go on a lot of adventures together. It's really nice. But then, these bad men, they try to capture you and Trico. And it's really not nice. So you have to be careful to get, you don't get caught. This is a lot of fun. this one of the games that you play it, and then you finish it, and then maybe a year later, you pick it up again and play it again, because the graphics and the art, they're really wonderful. I like video games that have a lot of nice art. Because I want to be an artist one day when I grow up. Maybe a painter, a drawer, or maybe make video games. Once I get my brain fixed, you can borrow that too. I know some people say video games are stupid and dumb, but let me show you something. You see, this is a book of the art of the Last Guardian. There was actually art that goes into making video games. You have to get an artist to draw the creatures and things like that. Even programming can be an art, and even level design can be an art, and things like that. It's not just, you know, simple. It takes a lot of skill to make a video game. Some art, a lot of art too. And that's why I think the arts are very important. People say art is not important, but well, if it wasn't for people who make music and people who draw and paint and color, then we wouldn't have a lot of things that we have today that we like. Let me show you just one thing in here. I'll show you some. See this? Look at that. Someone had to sketch all that. Different levels and things and items and all that. Buildings and all that. And I'll show you something else too. Where is it at? Yeah, there was like, it's not really, I think it's like computer generated maybe, but there's like a, it's concept artwork of Tweeko. So, there. So if you want to look at this, you can look at that too. I tap on things a lot. I hope you don't mind. It's one of my favorite sounds. Okay. I'll show you some of my other video games. You can borrow these ones too. This is Bloodborne. This is a really difficult game even for me, but I like it a lot because it reminds me of my favorite books. And you fight like werewolves and other types of creatures, beasts and things, even some other people. And you can even play cooperatives. So this one is, you can borrow that one. understand what's next. Oh yeah, Horizon Zero Dawn. This is one of the best games ever in the whole entire universe for all times ever. You get to play as a girl, and you go around with a bow and arrow, and you shoot all these bad machines, and you have to go find out. Well, I don't want to tell you in case you never played it, but this is one of the most awesome games ever. And when Oliver tells you, that's me. Remember, I like Oliver more than Benjamin. When Oliver tells you that one of the games is the best game ever, and then you should play it, okay? You can borrow that one too. This one is called The Last of Us. This is another one of my favorite games of all time ever in the whole Y universe. They're coming out with a number 2, I think. I don't know when, but I can't wait. Because the Ellie, the girl, she's all grown up. But it's going to be a lot more for adults. Not so much for kids. And then, this is Fallout 3. I have tried to play Fallout 4, but I keep forgetting about it. I was playing some other games like The Witcher 3 and these games here and XCOM 2 and Fallout Shelter and God of War with his son Atreus. And what other games I was playing, some other ones, but yeah, this is Fallout 3. I played most of this one. I still have to finish it. You can borrow that one too. Okay, I'm gonna show you some of my movies, my favorite movies you can borrow. Okay. The first one is Dark City. This is one of my favorite games. One of my favorite movies. Is about a man who his brain is kind of mixed up, and he lives in this weird city that keeps changing. And there's these strange people, and there's this doctor. He's almost like Dr. Corvus a little bit how he talks. So this is one of the movies. If you've never seen it before, you should go see it. You can borrow that too. Put everything right here on the experiment table for you. Let the Right One In. This is a really nice story about a girl who's something peculiar about her. I'm not gonna tell you about it unless it tells you in here. And a little boy. It's really nice. But kind of scary too. But Oliver, he recommends this one. And then the next one of my favorite movies is Inglourious B-Word. I'm not allowed to say that word. Inglourious Bastards. It's a really bad word. I can get a phone in Margaret's Garden for saying that word. And other bad words. Which I won't say none of them. But this is a really fun movie. If you like war movies, you can watch that one. My next favorite movie, American Psycho. I really like this one a lot. It's about a man who does some bad things to some people. There's one of my favorite parts. He says, don't just stare at it, eat it. I don't get it, but it's funny. Okay. My next favorite movie ever is Alien. I really like this movie a lot. It's about an alien that in space and eats up people on a spaceship. It's really scary, but there's a woman and she fights alien, and I'm not gonna tell you how it ends in case you've never seen it. And then my next favorite movie, Evil Dead 2. I think there was three of them. This is really good. And it's Bruce Campbell held to the king, baby. This is where I think that he gets his arm cut off and he puts a chainsaw on it. This is a really fun movie to watch. I know you're probably thinking, if I'm only 8 years old, why am I watching scary movies? Well, there's something about being scared that I really like. I don't know why. They give me nightmares, but I just really like it a lot. I can't explain it. I like to go on the amusement rides here at the sanitarium, the amusement parks they have here. I like to walk around the cemetery, but I don't like being in Margaret's garden. I don't like really, really scary things. But movies, I like scary movies because it's just a movie. It's not real. And then my next favorite movie is Bambi. This is really, really good movie. There's really, really scary part in it. And that you can watch that one too. Okay. So it looks like you're getting really sleepy. So I have some comic books with me, but maybe I'll come back another time that I showed you my action figures and my video games and these things, and I don't want to show you everything at once. Then I can come back again, I can show you some of my comic books. I also got I went to the gift shop, and they had Magic the Gathering and Yu-Gi-Oh! I think that's how you say it. And Pokemon, it's upside down, but there was Pokemon. And then new Hot Wheels car, the Batmobile. But how about I save those for another visit? Okay, would that be all right? Because I show you a lot of things and you're getting sleepy and I have to go before. You're not supposed to be here this long after you're done with your doctor, because there might be another patient that's going to be coming in here. So, and then I'll come back. And if you want to see me again, you just, then we can hang out again and I can bring you some more things, okay, that you can borrow. And I'll pick up my other things. You can drop them off in my room. Okay? How about I read you from... Let me just put my backpack there. How about I read you from one of my favorite books? This is by Robert Howard. The Coming of Conan the Cimmerian. And he is the author that wrote, that invented the Conan character from the movies and everything. Almost the same kind of style as my other favorite author, H.P. Lovecraft. You know, the one that wrote about the true stories of things that really happened in Arkham, and Innsmouth, and things like that. They actually corresponded with each other. So I thought that I would save this for last and do a little story, read a little bit of some of it, then you can fall asleep, and then I'm gonna go back to my room. Then if anybody comes and say, well, these toys are here, just say they're from a real friend. It's okay. I won't get in trouble. Okay, so let's see what stories we have. The Phoenix on the Sword. The Devil in Iron. The Veil of Lost Women. Rogues in the House. Pool of the Black One. Zuthal of the Dusk. X-U-T-H-A-L. Zuthal of the Dusk. Iron Shadows in the Moon. Black Colossus. Queen of the Black Coast. That's a really good one. They're all good. The Scarlet Citadel. The Tower of the Elephant. This is a really good one. I'll read some of this one. I'm not going to be able to read all of it, okay? Maybe a page or two, okay? And you can just... you know, fall asleep if you want, okay? I just want to say right now, Foy, it was really nice to meet you, and thanks for letting me come visit, and I hope that maybe we can, you know, hang out again, okay? That would be really mean a lot to me, okay? Alright, so I'm going to read now, and if you, go to sleep, it's okay. I'll just leave the things here that you can borrow, and then you can return them, okay? And then maybe I'll see you in the cafeteria, okay? The Tower of the Elephant. Torches flared murkily in the on the revels in the mall, where the thieves of the east held carnival by night. In the mall, they could carouse and war as they liked, for honest people shunned the quarters, and watchmen, well paid with stained coins, did not interfere with their sport. Along the crooked, unpaved streets, with their heaps of refuse and sloppy puddles, drunken roisterers staggered roaring. Steel glinted in the shadows where wolf preyed upon wolf, and from the darkness rose the shrill laughter of women and the sounds of scufferings and strugglings. Torchlight ricked luridly from broken windows and wide thrown doors, and out of the doors stale smells of wine and rank sweety bodies, clamor of drinking jacks and fists hammered on rough tables. Snatches of obscene songs rushed like a blow in the face. In one of these dens, merriment thundered to the low smoke-stained roof where rascals gathered in every stage of rags and tatters, furtive cut purses, rearing kidnappers, quick-fingered thieves, swaggering bravos with their wenches, strident-voiced women clad in tawdry finery, native rogues wear the dominant element, dark-skinned, dark-eyed Zamorians with daggers at their girdles and guile in their hearts. Don't know what that word means. But there were wolves of half a dozen outland nations there as well. There was a giant Iberborean renegade, Taciturn, dangerous, with a broadsword strapped to his great gaunt frame, for men wore steel openly in the mall. There was a Shemitish counterfeiter with his hook nose and curled wool-black beard. There was a bold-eyed Brethunian wench sitting on the knee of a tawny-haired Gunderman, a wandering mercenary soldier, a deserter from some defeated army, and a fat, gross rogue whose bawdy jests were causing all the shouts of mirth was a professional kidnapper come up from distant Koth to teach woman stealing to Zamora.